of the two of us, nobody knows us. Get in the car like...
Hi guys! Whoa! Hi guys! So, good morning-ish. It's actually 2 o'clock in the afternoon, but it is Saturday, so it is still morning for me. Say hi!
Say hi, Bo. Hello, everyone.
Say hi, Jasper.
Hello, everyone. Aw, you look so happy.
I just wanted to vlog for you guys. I just made some food. I went to Trader Joe's yesterday. I put a poll up on Instagram asking you guys what you liked from Trader Joe's, and I got a bunch of good recommendations, so thank you for that. But I am making these steamed chicken soup dumplings, so xiaolongbao if you know what that is. I've been obsessed with, I'm Din Tai Fung forever, so I wanted to try at home stuff because Din Tai Fung, that adds up. So let's see how these are. And I also wanted to show you guys a little haul of things I got from Target. As you guys know, I'm obsessed with home decor. I like been on Pinterest a lot lately, and here are a couple of like inspiration pictures, and literally this is the same decor style. So this is the collection of items I got from Target. I went a little crazy, but I'm happy with everything that I got. And then I also got some stuff online, which is going to be coming later on this week. So this is the xiaolongbao. I mentioned this on my Instagram, and I know for like a lot of my friends that are in college, it's really hard to find time to cook meals, or like they just don't like cooking or don't know how to cook. And they have a lot of frozen foods at Trader Joe's that like are really easy to make and that are delicious. And Trader Joe's, I feel like if you don't go there ever, you may assume it's kind of like whole food pricing, but it's not. I would say it's like cheaper than like your kind of big name brand markets like Safeway or like Whole Foods or, you know, anything like that. So definitely try it out. I feel like it's pretty common. I'm not trying to say like, oh, I discovered Trader Joe's. Like, no. But all I gotta say is, if you look at the dogs right now, they're just like hovering all around me right now. Bo, you can't have any of that. It's really good, but it's not for the puppy. No. But yeah, if you haven't tried Trader Joe's and you fit any of those categories, I definitely recommend trying it, because I just like always shop at Trader Joe's now. I never go to other grocery stores ever. Just want to show you guys some of my favorites that we always get every time we're at Trader Joe's. So this is their orange chicken. If you like Panda Express's orange chicken, this is like comparable. Really, really good. And their Kung Pao chicken is also very delicious. And if you, I mean, I feel like rice is super easy to make, but this is a really cool shortcut. The puppies, you guys are so cute. This is brown rice. All you have to do is put it in the microwave for 3 minutes and it steams it in this bag. And the rice is so yummy, so fast and easy. And you can just like make something, make a thing of rice and then make some like orange chicken or the Kung Pao chicken. And then I have like just bell peppers that are frozen, already cut, just to add in the rice for some veggies. And then just get like salad kits for vegetables as well. And then if you like edamame, they have edamame that's lightly salted and everything. All you have to do is put it on a plate, put it in the microwave for like 20 seconds, and then you have a bunch of edamame. So it's a really cool snack or just a side dish. We always get it at restaurants, and honestly, this is the exact same thing. It tastes the exact same. So you get a whole bag of it, and you're good to go. So I have my little makeup bag and then my iPad. I've been watching a lot of Netflix recently, and I'm currently watching the Fyre Festival documentary, and it's so interesting because I remember a couple years ago when that was all over Twitter and Instagram, people were freaking out, and I felt like, I didn't really look too into it, but I was like, that looks like just a shit show. And now like delving into it and seeing like the beginnings of it all and watching it all unfold gives me so much anxiety, just because I can't even imagine being on either side of the situation. So that's super interesting. If you want some recommendations for Netflix, definitely recommend that. I also just finished the Ted Dundee basically like a multi-episode series where they talk about just help you. Excuse me, I'd like to make an order. I would like some of your dumplings, please. Thanks. And especially interesting because it takes place at UW in Seattle, which is, I literally like was there a lot. I attended UW Bothell, so not the same location, but I was at UW Seattle more often because I was always out in the Greek system. And I met my boyfriend actually at that college, and that is the same college that he went to, and he killed a bunch of people, or women, young women like specifically. So it's so weird seeing like old clips of that college and like just thinking like I was around that area and decades ago this is what happened there. Insane. And I'm really into like crime documentaries. Sorry if you hear a little like skittering around, it's because the dogs are playing. I like am so used to it now, I don't hear it, but I feel like now that I'm filming I realize how loud they are, so excuse that. It's just them having the time of their lives running around this apartment and causing havoc. I'm really into like crime shows and like Forensic Files or like Criminal Minds, like profiling, psychology, all that stuff. And I mean, this guy was disgusting, and like it's so just horrific the things that he did. But yeah, definitely recommend that if you're into crime shows. It's a really well put together documentary. And then You also, series You, it's a show. They had their first season, I'm sure you guys heard of it. Definitely recommend that. The guy's very creepy, but it's really interesting. Yeah. So far, those are the three shows I've recently like been binging and like currently watching a documentary about fire. But, and also The Final Table, if you like cooking shows, Final Table is a really, really good show. If you're into culinary arts. Just did a little quick natural makeup look. Just some bronzer, highlighter, lip gloss, a little face stuff. Yeah. So I'm watching this documentary and this stuff is crazy. It's like apocalypse. Like apocalypse in the Bahamas. Alright, I wanna show you guys what I got from Target. Okay, where should I put my camera? Let's do this on the floor. Hello. I get a lot of questions on what breed Bo is. So he is apparently Shiba Inu Pomeranian, but he is 35 pounds. So we don't think he's part Pomeranian. We think he's a Shiba mixed with like American Eskimo or something like that. All right. So I'm gonna show you guys what I got. So I guess I'll, you guys really, okay, go, away, away, go away, or sit in front of me because you're so cute. Oh, oh, good boy. Wait, can you say bye, 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 say bye, Jasper, say bye, bye. Ah, so cute. All right, Jasper's ears gonna be in this entire video, I guess. So I got a lot of like pots and vases and just like ceramics because I've been really liking the look of just muted, cool kind of rustic ceramics just to put on shelves and tables and put little like pops of green from like stems and things like that. So I'm gonna show you guys all the different ceramics I got. Oh, I can't see anything. So this is the first one I got. It's definitely one of my favorites. I just love the little things of white, and the finish of it is very like, I wanna say it reminds me of Bali. A lot of this stuff reminds me of Bali. Just muted colors. Colors are a huge thing for me. I've never been a really big fan of really vibrant colors like hot pink and red and orange. I think for me personally, decor is all about how it makes me feel, and I like being relaxed and like cozy at home. So that's why I've always tended to stick to a more muted color palette, because I feel like colors don't clash. Things just kind of work together, and texture is a huge thing in this specific design or decor style. So the different texture in the ceramics is really cool because you have different patterns and different glazes. And here's another one. It has a really pretty intricate like floral design. And I actually have two of these now. It's the same pattern, but different pots. This one is from my friend Kara. She knows me so well. She got this for me as a present, and I actually got this on my own, and I really, really like it. It's really pretty. And then like this one here has this really cool kind of rock effect. And then there's this little guy here. I just loved the color, how it kind of complemented the white and like this. Very just simple. This is a tea light holder, so I can put like a little candle in there if I want and it'll like glow, or I can just like have it next to other things. Got this little guy, and this is a vase. It's tiny, but they had a ton of like different sizes in this kind of color combination. So it's just a really cool glaze, and then kind of a rough glaze at the bottom. So that different texture is really cool. And then I got two larger vases. This one here is awesome. I love it because it's a concrete vase. And I've been really into concrete like plant holders, like big ones or vases like this. And it's so cool that Target actually had them, because usually you have to order things like this online and they're very expensive. Like overly expensive. And so all these vases range from about like, I mean the smaller ones, like this one is $5, and this one was probably the most expensive one and it's $25. So it's a little pricier, but I mean compared to, I've been doing so much research on home decor, these things can run just like ridiculous prices, like $80. And I'm like, it's vase, like it, there's no way it needs to be that expensive. So I was really happy about that. And then I got all these individual stems and kind of put them in different vases to see how I liked them. And then going along with greenery, I got some more fake floral or greenery arrangements. So fake plants. And this is also in a cement pot. This is just like really cool pop of green. Oh, I forgot to mention I got this pot as well, or this vase. And it's just really pretty clean white. And I feel like the contrast with this and like this color is really pretty, or like pops of green. It's just really like this combination right here. I love it. I gotta say Target is starting to get a little bit more expensive, because I feel like I'd usually pay less for something like this. But these items are by far my favorite things I've ever gotten from Target, and that's saying so much. I don't know where my phone is, so I'll have to look for that later. But anyways, continuing our conversation. So yeah, I love this plant, and it came in this white pot, which I thought was super cute. And I was like playing around with different baskets, and let me tell you, I'm gonna insert this picture right now. If you need some baskets, go to Target right now, because they have any and every basket you could possibly think of, shape, size, color, whatever. So I was thinking this was like the perfect size. Last plant piece is this guy right here, and he was also $25. So not the cheapest, but not the most expensive for sure. I've definitely spent more on fake plants before, but I, at this point, half of my plants are dead from the time I was just out of town. So I've just come to a consensus that I need more fake plants. So yeah, no, this is really cool little pop of color. I got these two pillows. This here, I swear, I literally saw this like in Bali. This is a little toss pillow. Really cool fraying and crochet. I just think that like in a chair or on the couch, just a nice contrast, because I have a gray couch, so I want a lot more like cool like boho pillows, so white. And I have some I ordered from Lulu in Georgia, which I will include a clip here if I get them before I upload this video. If not, I'll include a picture of what I got. Or and then this other pillow I got, also white, little cushion thing, and I don't want to get any makeup on that. And then little baskets. So I got this little guy here. Don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I might put like a plant in it or store like remotes or little doodads or something, but I just thought it was super cute and it was $15. And then this here, I've never seen a basket this size and shape, and I just thought it would be so cool, maybe put like in a guest bedroom and have like necessities, like, you know, extra toiletries or folded up towels in the bath. I got this guy here. It's a little canister. You can open it up and you can just put cool things in that. Like, I was thinking keys or I don't know, just even having it just on display with no purpose for it, I'd be happy with it because I just love the look of it. Lastly, I have these two picture frames, and Target always has these frames, and they have a, I think in black as well, but I really liked the gold. All right. So yeah, that's my little, or big fat haul, I should say. This is not a small haul, but I'm very, very happy with everything that I got. It's exactly what I've been wanting, and I got it done in one place at the same time. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I just clobbered you. Oh my god, Bo. Why are you humping him? No. Oh my god. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Why are you eating your tail? Oh, I love you, babies. You want to say bye to everyone? All right. So I hope that you guys enjoyed today's vlog. Be sure to comment below with what other videos you want to see me do. And as always, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and press that notification thing down below. I've never once said that, but I feel like that's pretty important. To do if you want to see more of my videos. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Bye. Jasmine, say bye.